So the first reading today in the ordinary form is from the book of Numbers, and it's the story of the bronze serpent, where the people are continually complaining against what God has asked them to do through Moses, and because of their complaining and their infidelity, the Lord sends these seraph serpents, these fiery serpents with burning venom, among the people. And when the people repent and ask forgiveness, the Lord has Moses make a bronze image of the serpent and lift it up on a pole. And as many as look at the image lifted up on the pole are healed from the venom and are restored to life. And this parallels a part of the passage in the Gospel of John today, where our Lord speaks about being lifted up. It's one of the places in John where John records our Lord speaking about being lifted up from the earth. And this one is very interesting because it's one where twice in the very relatively short passage, our Lord claims for himself the divine name, I am. Ego eimi in Greek, ego sum in Latin. And in fact, the second time he does it is in relation to that being lifted up in that parallel passage to the lifting up of the bronze serpent, where he says, when you lift up the Son of Man, then you will realize that I am, and that I do nothing on my own, but I only say what the Father taught me. And so there's this idea, and it's one of these things that John brings out in a couple of ways in his telling of our Lord's life, something he thinks is important, he's inspired to make known to us, is that our Lord's glorification, our Lord's making known his divinity, that he is the Son of the Father, that he and the Father are one, this happens not just in the resurrection and the ascension, but it happens even in the cross. So in that moment, when in human terms it looks like our Lord's life is coming to the end in the most ignominious way possible, he's actually being glorified in being lifted up. Because in that being lifted up, he becomes for us healing, and that's how and salvation, and that's how his divine power is shown forth. Not in that image, that prefiguring with an image of a bronze serpent that heals them from natural venom, that and he restores them to natural life, but in this supernatural restoration that heals in us the wound of the ancient serpent dealt to us by the enemy, by the devil, when he seduced our first parents away from obedience to God. And in our Lord being lifted up on the cross then, and when we look upon him whom we have pierced, when we look upon him with faith and love and hope, when we look upon him with devotion, when we unite ourselves to that cross, then we are given healing, not just a bodily healing, but a healing for the soul, a restoration to eternal life, to that divine life that our Heavenly Father desired for us from the beginning. And therefore, especially now in this time of coronavirus pandemic, when we probably feel like we have a lot of extra crosses to bear this Lent, right? All the regular things plus the cross of not being able to worship together, not being able to receive the Eucharist, not being able to see family and friends, and for some of us, unfortunately, the cross of having family and friends very sick, or even who have been killed by this disease, by this pandemic. And yet the reality is that our Lord shows us in his cross that that death is now just a stepping stone to eternal life. And so if we unite ourselves to his cross, if we pick up our own crosses and unite ourselves in faith and charity to the cross of Christ, then when the Son of Man, who has been lifted up, he will heal us. He will heal us from our pain. He will heal us from our suffering. He will heal us, most importantly, from the wound of original sin, and restore to us not just friendship with God, but giving us adoption as sons and daughters of our Heavenly Father. And therefore, we will be given eternal life, not just a life of the body, but life of the whole person, life of the soul that is immortal, life in the new heavens and the new earth when everything is restored. And so I think if we keep that in mind and we keep our focus, especially as we go through Passion Week and Holy Week into Easter, if we keep that our focus, that will enable us to bear with the crosses we now have to bear with, especially the unique crosses of these circumstances during the pandemic, because they will allow us then to unite ourselves to the cross of Christ, and looking on him whom we have pierced, we will receive healing, just as the Israelites in the desert received healing from the fiery seraph serpents when they stared upon the bronze image that Moses lifted up on the pole. Please stay safe out there. As always, I'm remembering you in my prayers and my masses. Say an Ave for me if you get the chance, and remember that God is in control.